Welcome to our today's class, and I have a question here that has been extracted from a topic called calculus, and more specifically, it has actually been able to get extracted from a concept called differentiation. But again, the question demands that we use this concept of differentiation to unravel whatever is actually behind each and every part of this question, in as far as motion is concerned. So I'm going to read the question first, then we shall be able to get to the questions themselves, which are actually brought under that question. So the question reads, that is question 25, the displacement s meters of a moving particle after t seconds is given by s is equal to 2t cubed minus 5t squared plus 4t plus 2. Determine part A, the velocity of the particle when t is equal to 3 seconds. Part B, the value of t when the particle is momentarily at rest. Part C, the displacement when the particle is momentarily at rest. And lastly, part D, the acceleration of the particle when t is equal to 3 seconds. So the question demands that we actually use the concept of differentiation to move from displacement to velocity and from velocity to acceleration. But first, what is displacement? Displacement is a very good example of a vector quantity that has both magnitude or size and direction. That means the distance a particle covers in a specific direction. But distance itself is a scalar quantity, which only has magnitude but no direction. So to actually move from displacement to velocity, because the question asks us to get the velocity of the particle when t is equal to 3 seconds, time has been given. We cannot be able to plug this value into this equation because we shall actually be getting the displacement. So we shall first have to differentiate this equation of displacement for us to get the equation of velocity. Then where there's t, you can put 3 for us to get the velocity of that particle. So I'm going first to differentiate the equation. And the question reads, S for displacement is equal to 2t cubed less 5t squared, correct, then plus 4t, then of course plus 2. So if I want to differentiate this equation, I'm going to have this. I'm going to have ds dt. That means I want to differentiate the equation for displacement with respect to change in time. Ds dt. Just like the way someone can say dy dx. You differentiate the equation of y with respect to change in x. So I shall begin. I'm going to have this power getting multiplied by the coefficient of t. So I'll have 2 times 3. Then I'll reduce that power by 1. Then I'll say minus 5. Again, I multiply by the power, which is actually going to be times 2. Then I say t raised to 2 minus 1. Then lastly, I'm going to have plus 4. I assume this t has 1 as its power. Then I'll say now 1 times 4. This was 5 times 2. 5 times 2. Then t, that is raised to 2. Then minus 1. Then plus 4 times 1. Correct, 4 times 1. Then I'll have t raised to 1 minus 1. Correct. So, the equation for velocity will be 2 times 3, that gives us 6 t squared, 3 minus 1, that is t squared, okay, less 5 times 2, that is going to be 10 t, that is 2 minus 1, 5 times 2 is 10, then 2 minus 1, that is 1, then plus 4, that is 4 times 1, then we shall not actually write t because that will be 1 minus, which is actually going to be 0. So this is the equation for velocity. And because I've actually asked us to get V, so V is equals to unknown when T is given as 3. We shall just come here and say that V is equals to 6 into 3 then squared less 10 into 3. T is 3. So there's T, you put 3. For us to get the answer, then we shall say plus 4. So finally, we are going to have 6 into 9 less 30 plus 4. Okay, that is going to be 54 less 30 plus 4. Where have I gotten 54? That is 6 times 9, then minus 30, 10 times 3, and then plus 4. So we have 54 less 30 plus 4. That gives us 28. So our answer is 28 meters per second. That is the velocity when time is equals to 3 seconds. Correct. Let's go to the next part of the question. The question tells us to get the value of t when the particle is momentarily at rest. Okay. When the particle is momentarily at rest. What is t? When the particle is momentarily at rest. What is t? Okay. First, the velocity of the particle is given as, okay, 6t squared minus 10t plus 4. That's the question for velocity of this particle. The question of velocity of the particle. But now, you see, the particle is momentarily at rest. In any case, a question tells you that the particle is momentarily at rest. That tells you that now the velocity is zero. When I'm actually at rest, I'm not moving at any speed. My motion is not actually having any quantity. That means that body or that particle or I myself, I'm at rest and my velocity is zero. So when the particle was momentarily at rest, then that meant that the velocity of that particle was zero. So I'll say zero is equal to 60 squared minus 10t plus 4. This is a very good quadratic equation with three variables in the form ax squared plus bx plus c. So we shall actually be able to use either the quadratic formula or the completing square method or the factorization method for us to get the value of t when that particle is at rest to mean its velocity is zero. Okay. So I'll use what you call the sum product method or the factorization method, where the sum is equals to the coefficient of x as the middle term, that is now b, is going to be the sum, which is negative 10. So our sum is negative 10. Correct. Then what is our product? Our product is going to be, we can come here and take a, which is 6, and c, which is positive 4. For us to get our product. So that is going to be 6 times 4, which is going to be 24. So our A is 6 and our C is 4. So 6 times 4 can give us the product. But now the coefficient of X as the middle term can give us the sum, which is negative 10. So we're going to look for two numbers. When you add them or you get their sum, you have to get negative 10 and their product can give us 24. Let's see. Possibly, we may not actually talk much about the sum. We shall more focus on the product, which is 24. So we're going to actually end up having a pair of numbers that can give us a product of 24 and confirm whether they can actually give us still the sum of negative 10. So we have 6 times 4 that can give us 24. We have as well 8 times 3 and 12 times 2. Now, even if magic gets applied, there's no way in which you can actually use 8 and 3 to get a sum of 10. It's not that even possible. So we're going to actually remove that. So that now ends up giving us only two possibilities. So let's see. 6 times 4 is 24. Okay, but now 6 plus 4 is not negative 10. That means you can actually make them negative and see whether it will work for us. So let's see. Negative 6 times negative 4. Does it give us negative 10? If we multiply them, we get 24. If we add them, we get negative 10. So negative 6, okay, plus negative 4, it gives us negative 10. Then negative 6 times negative 4, that gives us 24. Of course, negative times negative, the answer is positive. Correct. Let's proceed. Now we are going to actually arrive at the final answer in terms of the values of t. So we shall proceed. We shall come here and have now 6t squared minus 10t plus 4. Where there is negative 10 as the middle term, I'm going to replace that part with negative 6 and negative 4. So I'll have 6t squared minus 6t minus 4t plus 4. Great. So that minus 6 minus 4 gives me minus 10 as the middle term. So I'll look for the common divisor. I'm going to have 6t into t minus 1, close the bracket, minus 4 into t minus 1. These two must be the same. So 60 times t, 60 squared, 60 times negative 1. That gives you negative 60. Minus 4 times t, minus 4t. Minus 4 times minus 1, positive 4. Okay. So we shall say 6t, okay, minus 4. So this and this are combined. 6t minus 4, then t minus 1. Correct. So we shall equate this to 0 for us to get the values of t. So 6t minus 4 is equals to 0. I'll take this on this other side. I'll have 6t is equals to 0 plus 4. And from there, I'm going to have this. I'm going to have 6t is equals to 4. If I divide both sides by 6, I'm going to get my t. My value of t as t is equals to 2 over 3. 2 there, 2, 2 there, 3. 2 over 3 seconds. That can be the first value of t. I can come here and say t, okay, just here. Okay, I can say t minus 1 is equals to 0. This other equation, because I'm done with this first one. I've said t is equals to 2 over 3 seconds. So t minus 1 is equals to 0. And again, I'll say t is equals to 0 plus 1. So again, when the particle is at rest, time can be 1 second. Okay, very good. Time can be 1 second. So that gives us now the two values of t when the particle is at rest. So it can either be 2 over 3 seconds or 1 second as time when the particle is at rest. That is done just in that easy way for you to arrive at the final answer in terms of what the question is asking. The third part of the question was asking us to get the displacement when the particle is momentarily at rest. When the particle is at rest, what is the displacement? It is very easy for us to get the answer. Why? Let's go back to the question and ask ourselves. What was the equation for displacement? We said S stands for displacement, and it is actually equal to 2t cubed minus 5t squared plus 4t plus 2. That is the equation for displacement. And they want us to get the displacement when that particle was at rest. Let's ask ourselves, when the particle was at rest, what was t? We have actually said that t was either 2 over 3 seconds or t was 1 second. So it's just easy. Just take the value of t, substitute in that equation where there is t for you to get the corresponding displacement or distance covered in a specific direction when that particle was actually at rest. So we shall say S, displacement, is equals to 2 into, and our t is 2 over 3. So shall say 2 over 3, cross the brackets, cubed, minus 5 into, again t is 2 over 3. So 2 over 3, close the brackets, squared, plus 4 into 2 over 3, close the brackets, plus 2. We want to get t when the particle was at rest. I'll just be able to use my calculator. I'll have 2 into 2 over 3, close the brackets, raised to 3. Then I'll say minus 5 into 2 over 3, close the brackets, squared. Then plus 4 into 2 over 3, close the brackets, then plus 2. We shall have the answer as 3 and 1 over 27. So the first answer is 3 and 1 over 27 meters, because we're talking about displacement, the distance covered in a specific direction. So we have S as 3 and 1 over 27 meters, the displacement of the particle when it was at rest. So let's actually go and use T as 1 again. So we have S again is equals to 2T cubed minus 5T squared plus 4T plus 2. Again, we shall say 2 into 1, then cubed, minus 5 into 1, then squared, plus 4 into 1, then plus 2. I'll again use my calculator for me to get the answer. Yeah, that is it. So we shall again have 2 into 1, close the brackets, cubed, minus 5 into 1, close the brackets, squared, then plus 4 into 1, close the brackets, then plus 2. So the answer is 3. So it is now displacement S is equals to 3 meters. So when the particle is at rest, it means it actually covered 3 and 1 over 27 meters, or it actually covered 3 meters. Correct. 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 So let's go to the last part of that question, which asks us to get the acceleration of the particle when t was 3 seconds. The acceleration of the particle when t was 3 seconds. I just come here and proceed. So you know very well that the equation for displacement has been given. We have differentiated that equation to get velocity. And now we can actually as well differentiate that equation of velocity to get acceleration. So from displacement in meters to velocity in meters per second, we differentiate. Then from velocity in meters per second to acceleration in meters per second squared, you also need to differentiate. So you have to actually give this in meters per second, and acceleration in meters per second squared. Okay. The equation for velocity was, as per what I've actually gotten here, 6t squared minus 10t plus 4. That is the equation for velocity. We are going to actually further differentiate that to get the equation for acceleration. So 6t squared minus 10t plus 4, the equation for velocity. So v is equals to 6t squared minus 10t plus 4, the equation for velocity. So we shall come here and say dv dt. I'm differentiating the equation of velocity with respect to change in time for me to get the equation for acceleration. What do I do? I just come here and say the power times the coefficient of t. So 6 times 2. Then I'll write t raised to 2 minus 1. Then less 10 at the same as raised to 1. Correct. So I'll say 1 times 10. So 10 times 1. Then t raised to 1 minus 1. The constant is always dropped when differentiation is getting there. So 4 has no use to us at this time when you further differentiate that equation from v to a. So we're going to further have now this as the equation for acceleration. A is equals to 6 times 2, that gives us 12 t, because that is 2 minus 1. Then we shall say minus 10 times 1, that is 10. Then this t raised to 1 minus 1, that gives us 0. So we'll drop that t. But here, we are not going to actually use 4. We have said we are differentiating v with respect to change in t. If that is a constant, it gets dropped. Okay, You have been told to get A when T is 3 seconds. It is easy for us. So A is equal to 12 into 3, that is T, then minus 10. That is going to give us now 12 times 3, that gives us 36. So 36 less 10, that translates into 26 meters per second squared. That becomes now our acceleration when the particle has to get considered when time given is 3 seconds. So thank you so much, and let's meet in our next lesson. Have a blessed evening.